Dad, looks like one of the Partridge Family All Right Yetis, everyone's favorite hot dog legend, it is Mr. Benjamin Cassidy!
Quick change.
Yeah. Hey, listen, I'm in.
Oh, stop.
I am. I'm in genuine fan mode. Genuine fan mode.
So am I. What? Really? I'm a big fan of the show, honestly. Yeah. Oh. It's BBC America, absolutely.
All right.
Yeah.
Do you have a Graham Norton scrapbook at home?
I have a dress.
Okay. Now,
stop.
Dave Cassidy, you're in our hearts, and now you're in our shops. Dave Cassidy, A Touch of Blue.
Indeed.
New album.
Brand new CD.
And these are all kind of on-release tracks. And
brand new tracks. We've had them live at Capitol Records in Hollywood.
And now, and you're going to be performing a lot of these, because you're touring, is it next April?
I start April 24th?
I said some tickets have been booked. But now, the thing is, I feel bad because this, I mean, what feel
new material.
No.
New CD.
New CD, that's all very good. But right. you have put in a bonus.
I haven't done that.
Oh, you didn't do
now,
that.
Now, let's be clear. My record company decided it would be such a good idea to have a new, to have a new David Cassidy CD.
Yeah.
And put on it includes the bonus hit album featuring Could It Be Forever, Cherish, Daydreamer, and I Think I Love You. I Think
You Love Me.
I Love You.
Oh, okay.
Now, yes, I do.
And I feel you love me so much.
That I'd like to sing that song just for you.
Oh, now bless you. Wow. I mean, I am going to bully you into singing this.
Yes, you are. Trust me, that's the only way I'm singing.
I know. Did you ever? Because I read.
I love it. But don't get me wrong.
All right, okay.
I love the song.
Good.
It's a classic. It was number one record for me in 31 countries, except Britain, which,
interestingly enough, I didn't have the pocket money. And obviously, there's a lot of ladies here who are going to see you on tour around the country this time around.
God bless you.
Yes. It was a weird thing, and maybe I'm wrong about this, but I was looking at pictures of, and it was striking me to say, I think one of the things was, you were like the prettiest person we'd ever seen. We'd never, like, people here aren't bred like you. You know what I mean? As a compliment, but also as a kind of a, we'd slayed and sweet. Who was going to pin them on a wall? Unless it was with a dart. You were.
Well,
God. I know it's very hard because it's you.
Yeah, well, it also was me. And I say that because it's like talking about, when people talk about me, they often talk about their first reference to me being famous. It becomes, for me, very difficult to move on, to have people understand that it was great and I loved it and I will talk about it endlessly as I am tonight.
Well,
no, but when people always want you to be there, it becomes impossible for you to move on. So I'd love to play something new for you, but for you, tonight, I will play because you said that.
It's so nice of you. And the weird thing, and I guess why people want to talk about it, because it's not like we're trying to trap you there.
But it does.
It does. But it's also that we're trying to just, it's how we felt then and how much we loved you.
Well,
that's what it's kind of about. It's about us remembering how special we were in our lives.
That's the issue for me.
I mean, it must be terrible for you.
Well, it's horrible.
You're it. We're kind of like, oh, and then, you know.
The wonderful thing.
And he's like, can everyone buy this new album? I feel like shit now. Can everyone just buy something? Just buy it.
be coming back.
No. I hope you will.
I think for me, it's always about, like all of us, we live in the present. And because of people and fans and people that have come and have been so supportive of me, and that's what I meant to say earlier, is that it's quite remarkable because I didn't come over here and work for so long. And I worked in the theater and on Broadway and in Las Vegas for 6 years. And to do that much work and not come back and to have people be that enthusiastic about today and to my last CD was...
Well, that's what I'm saying. I mean, that's the other thing. The last CD did incredibly well. Yeah, and, you know, you've had Dr. Nitz and things. So people are buying the new stuff. So cheer up. Anyway,
I knew this was going to be a mistake.
It's all a good thing. It's all a good thing.
Oh, yeah.
Now, listen. Now, you must know, in our lives, and I'm sure I've had some of you, those little cutesy special names, cutesy little special names that our dearest call us in the privacy of our own home. And obviously, those names shouldn't be repeated in public, and yet. People on the way in now, where's Chrissa Jenkins? Chrissa Jenkins?
What?
Oh, stand up, Chrissa. Stand up, Chrissa. No, that's not our baby name. That's our actual name.
Oh.
Yeah, no. There's Chrissa now. Chrissa, apparently, when you want something from your husband, Mark, you talk to him in a baby voice?
Yeah.
Like, what sort of baby voice?
Depends what I'm after.
What's the thing about Usher?
Usher?
If it's something really special that I want, it's Usher.
I read this here. Can I just say, I know what it means. You don't want to be doing that.
No.
Where does it come from, the Usher?
I think it occurred at the heat of the moment, and it sort of just stuck. I didn't say it.
Or is it like a torch? Why do you call him Usher? I don't...
Well, I didn't say it. I mean, I was taught not to talk with a mouthful at the time of filming.
Very good, Chrissa. Where's Shane? Where's Shane Carroll? Shane Carroll. Well, there's Shane. Well, stand up, Shane. Now, this is you and your boyfriend. You call each other. What do you call him?
Well, there's some occasions when I call him or refer to a past group as Yo-Yo.
Yo-Yo? Why Yo-Yo?
Well, we were on holiday and for some reason, sitting in a sort of a small coach that was on very bumpy ground.
I hear you. Yeah. That can happen on a London bus. We've all seen those people on the top deck trying to get off the bus like that. This is my stop. Now, listen, I'm quickly going to call, excuse me one second, going to talk to Jodie McGowan, where is she? Jodie? Oh, there's Jodie. Oh, stand up, Jodie. Right, so now, talk me through this. Your boyfriend, Wayne, right, he's ginger hair, and what do you call him?
Ginger bollocks.
Nice. Can I say, you don't want to know. If you didn't hear it, I'm not repeating it. Right now, we think that's not very romantic. What does he call you?
Chicken giblets.
That's not nice, is it, Betty? No! Oh, God. And then what's the thing, you get drunk and you want a bit of action. What do you say to him then?
Mama wants some
loving. Yeah, baby. Does he have a standard response to that?
Just say, get down, honey.
Nice. How long have you been together?
4 years now.
4 years?
Yeah.
Well, they're always having a laugh. They're having a nice life. But where is he now?
He's at home. I presume.
You presume?
Yeah.
All right. So, listen, if you phoned him, could you get him to say, get down on it?
Yeah.
Oh, I love that. Yeah, I could. So if you just said you didn't get in or something, pretend you get in and you're in a pub or a bit drunk. All right, yeah, okay, so just dial in your home number there now. Okay, what's his real name?
Wayne,
okay, Wayne. And this is Jodie, okay.
The key words we're looking for are get down on. That's how you're going to get into Mama Wants Some Loving. Good luck. Touring in Britain and everything, but you did do quite a bit of work here in that you've done two musicals here now. You did.
Yeah, I was in the West End in 87 doing, I refer to it as doing time, which I did.
Yeah.
I did time with the Laurence Olivier head. And,
yeah, it was a big hologrammy thing.
Yeah. It was actually a very successful show. And I also did, I did Blood Brothers on Broadway. And,
you won prizes, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it was a fantastic, because people of things like the Color Foreigns, they didn't imagine me playing a guy from Liverpool, and especially a 7-year-old from Liverpool. So it was really a wonderful production with Petula Clark and my brother, Sean, and it was extremely successful. And I did it there for a year, and then I did it on tour in America, and I came over here and did 3 months in the West End. Just because I really wanted to. And
was that scary during Liverpool
here? Yeah, because by the time I got here, my accent was crap. it was great when I opened on Broadway. People were, wow, and I got a lot of Liverpool press, went, I can't believe how great his accent is. But it's like music, you have to do an accent, you have to really hear the music. And I had a bunch of American actors, and once our director and everybody from Liverpool left after we opened, I was there with a bunch of American actors that had, NEF accents. So it was, let's see if I can remember anything that we did. I can't even do it. I could do a really bad one.
Oh, go on. Do a really bad one.
Hi, Dave. Dave? Please.
That was good. The break was very good. The break was very good. That was Brookside. That was Brookside.
But is it true? Are you going to stop? Are you going to stop touring? I'm not going to stop.
You better. I've got a palpable gasp. Let's kill him and take him home so he can never leave us.
I probably will not. This is supposed to be fun. My son asked me not to go away for long periods of time. He's 12. And I said, okay. What do you mean? Well, you go to Australia for a month, and you go to England and Europe, and you don't come back. And I have to stay here in school. And I said, okay. So it's not like I won't come over and do the odd show, but touring, doing a tour that takes 3 weeks or a month is probably something that, as I promised him, I wouldn't. I probably should keep my promise. And this.
Oh, everyone likes their kids.
Yeah, exactly.
You take it far too seriously.
Yeah. You're right. It's just that parenting thing. Yeah. Yeah. Trust that.
It is funny how parents take it much more seriously now than I think our parents ever did.
Oh, yeah. No,
yeah, I'll never tour again. Whatever. Yeah. You stopped crying, you went to bed. Fine. Not a tour. Now, we all have vices. Some of us, obviously, addicted to you. But, I don't want to discuss it. But it seems some people amongst us have darker, more peculiar desires. They want to share with the world. So come up here with me now while we play Poop Therapy. It's up here. Rejoin the Graham Norton Show.
Hello.
Now, there's people down here.
Yes.
And now they all have an addiction. And the idea is they're going to tell us what their addiction is, right?
They'll make, try to justify it or maybe explain it to us a bit.
And what's
and
our
then,
job?
And then we decide whether if we feel their addiction is a good one, then we all want to feel the love, there'll be a bit of a group hug in the audience. They're very excited. Like, I think they'll like them all. We're like, yeah, another group hug. And if we don't like it, then as one, we shall get our life. And a lot of people are here saying, if you've got things to throw, throw it. Okay, so who would like to share their problem first?
Hi, my name is Susie.
Hello, Susie. Hello, Susie. Can we do that again? Has he not been to therapy? Susie says hello, we say hello back. Try it again, Susie.
Hello, my name is Susie.
Hello, Susie.
And my addiction is to lip gloss.
Lip gloss?
Lip gloss.
Well, how much do you put on?
I put it on every day, about 25 times a day. And if I had to choose between a lip gloss and a man, a lip gloss would win hands down.
Okay, are we feeling good or get alive? Okay, ooh, getting alive here. Get alive. The video's on us. Get alive. Sorry, Susie. Okay, who wants to share a problem next? No, lovely lady there.
Hello, my name's Amy.
Hello, Amy.
I'm Amy and I'm a cereal drink dialer.
You're what?
A cereal drink dialer.
What's that?
Well, every time I have one too many to drink, my hands reach for the phone and I start to ring people I shouldn't be ringing.
We've all done that.
It started at a bar in Melbourne when I realised I had this addiction. I was with a friend and my battery went flat after ringing one guy in Sydney 3 times. Ooh. At this stage, I realised I have a problem.
Well, she's off on one now.
Are you
drunk now? I can see you.
My brain might not be working, but his fingers are.
Yes. 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 Yes, I think we understood the problem earlier. Earlier there was not a feel of the love. Now it's getting alive, I think. So what are we saying? Get alive! Get alive! I'm sorry, Amy. I'm sorry. No problem. No.
Shh.
No. The solution is hush. The solution is hush. Well done. Here we go.
Hi everybody, I'm Lewis.
Hi Lewis!
Hi, basically my problem is I've got an addiction to barbecue sauce sandwiches.
You know barbecue sauce?
Yes.
Here in Britain we put it between bread. We can't afford the ribs. Oh. So how many do you have?
Basically it's more of a nocturnal thing. I have to have about 4 or 5 before I can get to sleep. I wake up and I'm covered in brown bread crumbs.
I think we should get together with her on the phone.
And now, are we feeling that I quite feel the love on this one? No, oh no. Oh my god, it's just like a bank of bitches here. Everything I've got now, get out of feel a little love. No, are we not feeling love? No sympathy for anyone. Okay, now look, this can be the one. This can be the one we feel sorry for. Okay, off you go.
Hi, I'm Julie.
Hi, Julie!
I'm really sorry to say, but I'm addicted to David Cassidy.
Now we feel the love. Now, this is going to be good to follow that. Okay, quick. Hello.
Hello, my name's Sue.
Hi, Sue.
Oh, I'm sorry to say I've got a very bad addiction for bald men. I'm so ashamed. I've seen a few and I've tried to stop myself, but...
So now... So you are actually addicted to bald men?
Bald men, in a club, on a train, anywhere. It gets worse when I've had a few drinks.
So are you dating anyone at the moment?
I'm getting married in 2 weeks.
Presumably.
And he's not bald.
Now, call me madcap. That's not going to go well. Have you talked to him about shaving his head or anything?
I've tried.
Yeah?
He won't.
Now, you could, and people have done this, put Imac in a conditioner bottle.
Thank you.
Good idea. I'm so clever. I just thought of that.
I've seen a few bald heads around. I'll try and keep my hands in my pockets. Very difficult.
Is that what you just like to rub them?
Yeah, just love them.
All right, okay. So, now, I feel her pain. Are we feeling the love or good life? Feel the love. Good life for you. Well done. Okay, we must Essie's our favourite addiction. What are we thinking? Anybody? Tim Kathleen Warhead. David Kathleen addiction is our winner. Well done. That's Julie. Well done, Julie. Congratulations. And currently on my lovely friends at Klaus Kohler, the low alcohol lager, you want a luxury break for two to Cologne. Yes, yes. Yeah. David, I bullied you, and now you're going to do it. Thank you very much. If you want to go, get ready. There you go, and now, here with a special, special treat, it is the Fantastic, I Think I Love You! It's the Fantastic David Cassidy!
Better stick around and love you to keep.